Generation X. But Kang, what is Triple H going to do about these problems with his wife, Stephanie?
Oh, I don't know. I just hope that he doesn't have to endure any more heartaches tonight. You know, he's been sleeping single in a double bed all week. This is terrible.
And his opponent, Finger Company, to the ring by the Road Dog from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 220 pounds, X-Pac.
Now, Michael, first of all, let me just tell you, don't make too much out of this friendly rivalry deal. That's all it is a friendly rivalry. It's not a case of one-upmanship, as you like to call it. These guys are best buds.
I'll tell you, on Raw, X-Pac and Road Dog proved that they can win as a tag team. Perhaps one of the greatest tag teams in World Wrestling Federation history. But again, tonight, the threat of Roman, they can win one-on-one. And X-Pac and Scotty Too Hotty.
I realize that, but you just gotta look at this. This is like two good buddies playing golf or something like that.
Playing golf?
Yeah. Hey, look at this.
Oh, we're being joined by X-Pac's good friend, one half of D-Generation X, Road Dogg, is joining us here in ringside to get set for this matchup between X-Pac and Scotty Too Hotty. Welcome, Road Dogg.
Well, it's your pleasure. That's for darn sure, Michael Cole.
Road Dogg, I gotta ask you, the situation between your good friend, your best friend, Triple H, and his wife, Stephanie McMahon Helmsley.
Well, I'm not the National Enquirer, and I'm not the Globe. My friend, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, is very much in love with his wife. As a matter of fact, he's smitten over her, and I'm sure everything's going to be all right. They're going to talk things out. They just haven't had a chance to. Everything's been so chaotic.
Have you ever heard? You're right.
Look at X-Pac. Oh,
maneuver by X-Pac on the hip toss, and Scotty Too Hotty with the counter, and both men quickly to their feet.
Oh, look at this. See? Right there. That's the difference between my single wrestling ability and X-Pac. While he was dancing, I would have, King, you know what I'd have done.
Yeah, right. Just like a bad dance partner. You'd have stepped on his foot and then blacked his eye or something like that.
And when I got done, I'd have given him a dance lesson.
There you go.
Well, Road Dogg, if X-Pac wins this matchup against Scotty Too Hotty, he sort of puts the pressure on you to win your matchup against Grandmaster Sexay later on.
It puts a lot of pressure on me, but like I said, this is a friendly rivalry, and there's not that much pressure on me because the fact is that I will beat Grandmaster Sexay.
Scotty,
no problem.
Baseball slide, and X-Pac with a clothesline to the back of the head, and X-Pac in control of Scotty Too Hotty. Speaking of friends and friendly rivalry, not to harp on the subject, but get back to Triple H for a minute, Road Dogg.
Please,
it sounds like you're harping on the subject.
I'm just curious to see if you offered your friend maybe a little bit of friendly advice on how to deal with the situation.
I tell you what, marital advice is not something you
want. Wait a minute, cover by X-Pac. There's two and a kick out. Scotty Too Hotty.
I'll tell you, Michael's
the
like a regular.
Almost on.
Michael's a regular Dear Abby. He wants a dev into everybody's home life.
Their personal business.
You're calling me a Dear Abby.
Right.
Give me a break.
Dig into their personal business, Michael.
This is a molehill that's been blown up to a mountain.
Right. Nobody asked how you bleach your little sissy hair.
Oh, X-Pac working on Scotty Too Hotty. You liked that, didn't you?
Change the subject, Marshmallow Head.
And right. Scotty Too Hotty trying to battle back.
He can't foul out. Not against X-Pac.
Well, he sure did there, Road Dogg. Wait a minute. Reversal. The counter. Great suplex.
Well, Scotty
X-Pac into the cover. There's two, and Scotty kicks out before the count of three.
I'm glad it's just a friendly rivalry. I don't know if I'll be able to take up my end of the slack, tell you the truth. He's doing a pretty good job on Scotty Too Hotty.
We mentioned Road Dogg Grandmaster.
He ain't looking too hotty right now, is he?
Road Dogg Grandmaster Sexay later on, plus the big matchup made by Commissioner Foley.
What's he doing?
Uh-oh. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, again. He's got that Too Hotty.
Got that Don King dude going.
What's he doing? What is that?
Gaining momentum is what he's doing.
Wait.
No.
Look at this.
Come on, X-Pac. There you go. Reverse. Come on. Oh.
X-Pac kicks out before the count of three. That was a close one. Road Dogg sounded like a cheerleader hitting ringside for his friend X-Pac.
What do you think about that, Michael Cole? That just proves that these guys are best friends. Michael Cole is out here, Road Dogg, trying to make it like you guys are there's dissension there or something.
He's trying to stir the stew is what he's doing.
Oh, look at Road Dogg now. Bronco Buster time.
X-Pac misses with a Bronco Buster. It can Scotty Too Hotty battle back.
That'll leave a mark.
There goes Scotty Too Hotty.
King, I hate this.
Here it comes.
Oh, no.
That was
ankle.
Scotty, there's two. Can he get it? X-Pac.
No, his foot. His foot's on the rope. That's the difference right there between a veteran and somebody who can't even dance.
Look, well, Scotty doesn't realize what's happened here. He didn't win. That's what's happened.
Yeah,
X-Pac
exactly
wisely,
what
veteran maneuver, getting his foot on the rope, and Scotty Tuhani with the right hand to the side of X-Pac's head.
Close fist.
Well, that was a close fist, too.
That's it. That's it.
One, the X-Factor.
Three.
X-Pac picks up the win.
He may be up, but I tell you what, I'm going to try things up later.
What was a blatant low blow kick that allowed X-Pac to pick up the victory over Scotty Tuhani?